Okay, so in this video, we're talking about the law of signs. We're continuing our discussion about the law of signs. And I want to revisit a page we talked about in part one of the law of signs video. And it's when you can use the law of signs. We discussed in the first bullet that if you know two angles, then you can use law of signs automatically. And it doesn't matter which two angles you know. If you know an angle and then a side in between two angles, and that would be referred to as angle, side, angle. Or if you know two angles and then a side that's not in between, and that would be angle, angle, side. Okay, and we did problems like that in the last video, and those are what I call the easy cases. Well, in this video, we're going to talk about the more challenging when you know two side lengths and then an angle that's not between the two sides. So let's say in this green triangle down here, we know side B, we know the value of side C, and then we know angle A. Now that's called side-side angle. And all that really means is you know two sides and you don't know the one in between. Okay? Now, the side-side angle case gets a little bit tricky, because with side-side angle, you might have, well, you have three different possibilities that could happen depending on the information that's given. Did I spell possibilities right? Almost. There we go. All right. One situation is that you have no triangle exists at all. Like, say you said, you know, the length of B was 10 and the length of C was 5 and angle B was 56. I think I just made up one for you that's just not going to work out. Don't quote me on that. Don't even check. I just made it up off the top of my head. But it is possible that I could give you one that cannot happen at all. And that's the situation that no triangle exists. And then I could give you a problem that you have one answer or one triangle exists. And that's the most practical one. That's the one we think ought to happen every time, but not always true. And then the other crazy possibility is that two triangles exist due to the information that I gave you. So there's two different ways you could draw the triangle, which is going to give you different results. So there's a technique for doing these problems, and that's what I want to work on in this video. I want to show you probably a problem with each of these possibilities. The two triangle problem runs into a great deal of work, because really it's two separate problems that you're working. But let's talk about how to handle that with our first problem. All right, so here we go. The first thing I want you to notice when you look at this problem, because you're given a triangle problem, and you're not going to know how to approach it without having some technique in your head. So when I look at these, the first thing that I look at is, do I know two of the angles? And I don't, okay? Notice I know two sides. I know side A, side C, and only angle A. Therefore, this is not what I call one of the easy problems. Doesn't mean it's hard. It's just not one of the super easy when you know two angle problems. So here's the next thing I'm looking at. Do I know two bits of information referring to the same letter? In other words, do I know a side and an angle directly across from it? And using our naming convention, that means I have letters that match. And if I have letters that match, again, I know that's not application practical, so I want you to realize what that means. I have a side and the angle across from it. And as long as I have that, I can use law of signs. If I didn't, let's just say I had side A, side C, and angle B, then I wouldn't have enough information to use law of signs, and I would have to use a different technique, which is in the next video, which is called law of cosines. But right now, I have what I need to use law of signs, so let's just go ahead and jump in and use law of signs, okay? So here we go. I can set up the sine of 136 degrees, in other words, the sine of A over A, 57.5, is equal to. Now, I'm required to work with sine of C, angle C, because I have side C. So I'm going to say the sine of angle C over 49.8. That is my only option at this point. do the information I've been given. I've got to work with what I have, and that's all I can do. So the next step is I'm going to cross multiply. I'm going to say 49.8 times the sine of 136 degrees. Is equal to 57.5 times the sine of C. Now at this point you might be wondering, how am I going to solve for C? You know, whenever you're trying to solve for an angle within a trig function, you're going to have to use an inverse trig function to do that. So my next step is to divide both sides by 57.5. So I have 49.8 times the sine of 136 degrees divided by 57.5 is equal to the sine of C. Now again, to solve for C, I'm going to have to take the inverse sine of each side of this equation. So what I'm going to have here is the inverse sine of this entire expression on the left. So 49.8 times the sine of 136 degrees divided by 57.5 is equal to C. And I'm going to type all of that in my calculator. So when you type this in your calculator, make sure that you are in degree mode. Depending on the way your calculator, the order that it works, is how you handle it. What I could do is I hit my second sine, which gave me my inverse sine, and then I typed in 49.8. times the sine of 136, had to close out the parenthesis after the 36, divided by 57.5, I had to close out the big inverse sine parenthesis after that, and it gave me 36.98705386 that I am supposed to round to the nearest whole angle, so that would be 37 degrees. Okay, again, you might have to play with your calculator to make sure you're getting the same answer. So make sure you can do that in your calculator. So now we have a C value. Now here's where it gets interesting. We've got to find out, we know that there's at least one triangle, because if there wasn't, we would get an error in our calculator, and we would know there's no triangle that exists. So now we have a C value. We've got to figure out if there is a second C value. So to do our, I'm going to call it C2. And what you do to find C2 is you do 180 minus your found value. Okay. And to see is there a second triangle, what you do is you take your given angle plus your second triangle and see is that less than 180 degrees. If so, then you have a second triangle that you have to deal with. So let's try that. So my C2 again is going to be 180 minus 37 degrees, which gives me 143 degrees. Okay. Now I'm supposed to take my given angle. Now, what I mean by given, that is the 136 degrees I gave you. So 136 degrees plus the 143 degrees that we got for our second C. Now, y'all know that that is definitely greater than 180. So I could say that's not less than 180 degrees. Therefore, there is no second triangle. Okay. Now, we're not done with the problem. We just know there's no second triangle. So I'm going to summarize my results for this problem down in the bottom corner. Remember, looking for A, B, and C in angle form. Then I'm looking for side A, B, and C of side lengths. I'm given that A is 136 degrees. I just found out that C is 37 degrees. And I know that side A is 57.5. And side C is 49.8. Now I still have to find angle B and side B. Now, angle B is not going to be a problem, right? Because now we know two angles. So to find angle B, I'm going to do 180 degrees minus the two that we know, which is 136 degrees minus 37 degrees. And I get 7 degrees. It is very small, but it's valid, okay? Now, all I'm missing is side B. So to find side B, I need to use law of sines, okay? And I'm going to set up information I already know. Like, I think I'm going to work with sine of 136 degrees, which is angle A over side A, 57.5, is equal to, remember, we're looking for B now. So I'm going to say sine of 7 degrees over side B. I'm going to cross multiply. So I have B times the sine of 136 degrees is equal to 57.5 times the sine of 7 degrees. To solve for B, I'm going to say 57.5 times the sine of 7 degrees divided by the sine of 136 degrees. I'm going to type that in my calculator as is. So again, 57.5 times the sine of 7, make sure you're in degree mode, divided by the sine of 136, close out parentheses, and I get 10.08767409. I round that to the tenths place, so that'll be 10.1 units. Okay, and that is our first side-side angle problem solved. And notice we had, again, one triangle for this problem. All right, so we have another solve the triangle problem. Round side lengths to the nearest tenth and angles to the nearest whole angle. I look at this problem and the first thing I ask myself, is this one of the easy problems where we know two angles? It's not, right? We only know one angle of A is 12 degrees. So the next thing I'm asking myself is, can I even use law of sines? And I can, because I know a side and the angle directly across from that side. In other words, with our naming convention, the A's, we have both A's, side A and angle A. If you didn't have that kind of naming convention or you had an application problem, again, what I'm saying is the angle and the side directly across from that angle. If you know that, you can use law of sines. If you don't, you can't. And we do. Now the problem is, for this side-side angle situation, we might have no triangles, we might have one triangle, or we might have two triangles that meet this condition. So we've got to figure that out immediately. And to do that, we've got to solve what we can solve for. So in other words, I'm going to set up the law of sines saying that sine of A, which is 12 degrees, over 7, is equal to the sine of B over 28. That's all I can do. Now to solve for the sine of B, I've got to get the sine by itself. To do that, I need to multiply both sides by 28. So I have 28 times the sine of 12 degrees over 7 is equal to the sine of B. Now again, anytime you have to solve for an angle inside a trig function, you're going to have to use inverse of that trig function. So you have inverse sine of 28 times the sine of 12 degrees divided by 7 is equal to B. And I'm going to type that in my calculator. I'm going to make sure that I'm in degree mode. I'm going to hit my second sine button so I have an inverse and do 28 times the sine of 12, close out parentheses, divided by 7, and then close out another set of parentheses. And I get 56.268273888, but this is supposed to be rounded to the nearest whole degree, so B is 56 degrees. So I know I have at least one triangle at this point, but the question is, do I have a second triangle? So to find out if you have a second triangle, what you need to do is find out if there is a B2 by doing 180 degrees minus the B that we found. Okay, so 180 minus 56 gives me 124 degrees. Now, that won't tell us alone. Now, what we have to do is we have to take our known angle, which is 12 degrees, plus our second angle, which is 124 degrees, okay, and ask, is that less than 180 degrees? If so, that means there's room for a third angle, okay? So again, the A12 that we were already given, the alternative B, which is 180 minus the B we found, of 124. Now, 12 plus 124, I shouldn't have to do that, is 136 degrees, is less than 180. True, which means there is a second triangle involved in the story, okay? So, this problem just got interesting. We have, I'm going to put our summary over here on the far right. So, for triangle number one, we have, and better yet, let me do this in different colors. So, we can keep up with this a little bit better. So, let's do triangle one in red, okay? So, we have an A, a B, a C, and A, B, C, and let's fill in that information. So we know that A is 12. I'm going right at the beginning of the problem. Side A is 7, and side B is 28, and we went ahead and found that angle B is 56 degrees. And then in blue, we're going to have a triangle 2. Okay, and triangle 2 also has an A, B, and C for angle and A, B, and C for side lengths. The given information in the original problem is true for both of these. So side A is still 7, side B is still 28, and angle A is still 12. Now what's different about triangle 2 now is the second B value, your B2, is 124 degrees. Okay, now let's go back to triangle 1 and continue solving it. So basically we need angle C and side C, okay? So to find angle C, well, we know two angles now, so we can say C is 180 degrees minus the 12 degrees minus the 56 degrees, and that gives me that C is, right to my calculator, 180 minus 12 minus 56, and that gives me 112 degrees is angle C. And I'm going to put it down here in my summary. Now we can find side C by using law of sines. So I'm going to work with the information I was already given, which was the original angle A sine of 12 degrees over side A 7 is equal to, now I'm working with C. So I have sine of, this could be confusing, but that's 112 degrees over C. Now I'm going to cross multiply. So this way, so I have C times the sine of 12 degrees is equal to the 7 times the sine of 112 degrees. I divide both sides by the sine of 12. So C is 7 times the sine of 112 degrees divided by the sine of 12 degrees. And this is going to give me side C. So I'm typing this directly in my calculator. That's 7 times the sine of 112 degrees divided by the sine of 12 degrees. And I have 31.2. Remember, this is a side length, so I go out to the tenths place. All right, that finishes up triangle one. Now, triangle two, I was working on in blue. All right, so notice what we have. We're looking for the same information. So to find C2, then I'm going to do 180 degrees because every triangle adds angles to 180, minus the two angles we know, which is 12 degrees and 124 degrees. So that means C2 is 180 minus 12 minus 124, and that gives me 44 degrees. And now I can use law of sines. I can use law of sines to calculate side C. So I'm going to work with the information that was originally given. Okay, so I can say that sine of A, which is 12 degrees, over side A, which is 7, is equal to sine of C, which is 44 degrees, over side C. We don't know, that's what we're looking for. Now I'm going to cross multiply. So I can say C times the sine of 12 degrees is equal to 7 times the sine of 44 degrees. So C is equal to, I'm going to divide both sides by the sine of 12 degrees. So 7 times the sine of 44 degrees divided by the sine of 12 degrees. I type that in my calculator. 7 times the sine of 44 divided by the sine of 12. And I get 23.38785556. This is a side length, so I round to the tenths place, 23.4 units. And that is the end of this large problem. We have another solve the triangle problem. Again, to reiterate, when I look at these problems, no matter what section I'm in, I'm looking and going, do I know two angles? I don't, right? I only know angle A is 142 degrees. So it's not one of the easy problems. The next thing I'm looking for is, do I know an angle and a side across from that angle? In other words, are there matching letters? And there are, which tells me I can use law of sines. So I jump right in. The problem is, this is one of those side-side angle problems. So we have to be careful. We might have no triangles that exist. We might have one triangle that exists. Or like the last problem, there are two separate triangles that make this information true. So let's see what we can find out, and we'll start right off the bat with what we can work with. I can work with sine of A over A. So I'm going to say the sine of 142 degrees over 1.4 is equal to the sine of B over 2.9. Now it's time to cross multiply. All right, so I can say 1.4 times the sine of B is equal to 2.9 times the sine of 142 degrees. To solve for the sine of B, I'm going to divide by 1.4. So I can say 2.9 times the sine of 142 degrees divided by 1.4. Now remember, anytime you're trying to solve for an angle inside a trig function, you need an inverse trig function. So that's going to be the inverse sine of 2.9 times the sine of 142 degrees divided by 1.4. And be careful with your calculator. Pause the video if you need to see if you get the same answer as I do. How you enter this in your calculator can be tricky, just depending on your calculator. Mine is direct, so I'm going to say second inverse sine, and I'm going to 2.9 times the sine of 142, close out that parenthesis, divided by 1.4, and then close out the big set of parentheses, and I get error, and then it says colon domain. Different calculators say different things, but this is what we're looking at. This always makes me check it twice. If you check it again, I promise you will say the same thing. So what do you think our result is? This is no triangle exists. There is no triangle that meets these particular conditions. If you tried to draw it, what's going to happen is I'm trying to draw a 142 degree angle. That's what we've got going on. It says, and we can call that angle A, okay? And it says length B is 2.9. So this will be 2.9, and here's angle B over here, which means at the top is angle C. But it says the side across from A, this guy, is not long enough. It doesn't meet the other side. So, frowny face. It doesn't make it over there, and that's our problem. That's why no triangle exists. Next problem. I have a formula for you. This, to me, is a little bit of a novelty. I don't necessarily always put this on my tests. And it's not information that you don't already know, but I think it's worth taking a minute to look at. I usually assign homework problems using this. It says the area of a triangle equals 1/2 the product of the lengths of two sides times the sine of their included angle. They give you a figure, thank goodness, to help you see this. But y'all know what this is. You know the area of a triangle is area equals 1/2 the base times the height. Y'all, that's way back from geometry, way before geometry. You had this in middle school, I would imagine, calculating the area of a triangle. Now, let's look at it in the terms that they have, okay? So notice, let's take a look at this first one right here. If we talk about, this is angle A right here, right? Well, if I think about sine, if you'll recall, of theta, let's just say of anything, is opposite over hypotenuse. So if I look at this picture, the opposite right here is H, and the hypotenuse right here is B. So I could say that sine of A is H over B. Well, my formula up here, my old school triangle formula, has a height in it. So I solve this for H. So I say B times the sine of A, and then use that formula. So A is 1/2. This B is base. The base in my picture is C. And then the height right here is B times the sine of A. And look at our formula. That's 1/2 BC sine of A. And that's exactly what we have, except my CB is not in the same order. And that's perfectly fine. So basically, they're just still using the same old formula you already know, which is 1/2 the base times the height. One thing I do want you to realize when you use this is that the angle has to be between the two known sides. So if you're given angle B, it has to be between the 8 and the 5 that you were given. Okay? So again, over here, if I look at this picture, if that's 125, which it can't be, right? 125 is over 90 degrees, but let's just assume. And then it says side A is 8, so this would be your 8, and side C is 5, so that is between those two. So y'all, all we're supposed to do is plug it directly in the formula. So A is 1/2 B C, but we don't have a BC, but that doesn't matter, right? So, or you could look at this one, okay? So it's 1/2 AC, so 8 times 5 times the sine of 125 degrees. Main thing is make sure your calculator is in degree mode and just type right in. So that would be 1/2 of 8 is 4 times 5 is 20 times the sine of 125 degrees. I'm going to type that in. 20 times the sine of 125 gives me 16.383. I didn't tell you where to round on this problem, so let's just go out to the tenths place. So 16.4. Now it says yards. We're calculating area, so that would be yards squared. All right, our last problem from this video is an application problem. We have a pine tree growing on a hillside that makes a 75 degree angle with the hilltop. Okay, so you see they have a perfectly drawn picture here for you, which helps a lot. It says from a point 80 feet up the hill, so there's our 80 feet up the hill. It says the angle of elevation to the top of the tree is 62 degrees. Now, angle of elevation is calculated from horizontal, so there's your 62 degrees. And then it says the angle of depression is 23. And angle of depression is, again, from level down, so this is the 23 degrees. Okay, it says find to the nearest tenth of a foot the height of the tree. So we're trying to figure out right here how tall that tree is. We just need to find out that missing side length. And we can do that. If we need to draw a separate triangle over here, we can. Okay, and let's label what we know. So we know this is 75 degrees. How do we find that angle? We've got two different angles in there. How about we add the angle of elevation plus the angle of depression, 62 plus 23 gives me 85 degrees. So this angle is 85 degrees. I'm going to stick it on the outside. And again, we're looking for this value right here, okay? And we know this value. Now, is that enough to solve this problem? Well, sure it is. Matter of fact, this is one of our easy guys, right? Any time you know two angles, then finding using law of signs is not a problem whatsoever. Okay. Now remember, your law of signs, you're setting up the side across from the angle. So we have to set up a situation where we say the sine of 85 degrees over, you can call it H if you want to, these are across from each other, okay, is equal to, now, we have to work with this, which means we have to know that angle right there. Can we find it? Sure we can. We can do 180 degrees minus 75 minus 85, and that's going to give us that angle at the top, okay? So we have 180 minus 75 minus 85, and that gives me 20 degrees, okay? So this is 20 degrees, and then now I can say the sine of 20 degrees over 80. So you see how this works. You have to work with the side across from the angle you know. If you don't know the angle, you can find it, especially if you know the two sides, okay? I mean, the two angles across. So I did 180 minus the 75 minus the 85. That gave me 20. So I was able to set up sine of 20 over 80. And again, sine of 85 over the angle across from it. Let's cross multiply. So I'm doing 80 times the sine of 85 degrees is equal to H times the sine of 20 degrees. I'm going to divide both sides by the sine of 20 to get this H by itself. And that's going to be my final answer for this problem. I typed that directly in my calculator. I have 80 times the sine of 85 divided by the sine of 20, and I get 233. And it says to the nearest tenth of a foot. Well, that still gives me 233 feet. And you could say 233.0 feet if we do it to the nearest tenth of a foot. And that's my final result. Hope this helps.